Who's that, Harley? Who's that Batman?
Hello, Mr. Jones.
I said, who is that? Is that a kind man? Is that a good man? Is that a bad man? Is it the devil?
Maybe it's all of them at once. Maybe there ain't no devil. There's no kindness neither.
You is always a strange one, Harley. How is Mrs. LeClerc?
About as you'd expect.
I expect a lot. It's mighty bad business. LeClerc was a good man, a fine man.
That he was.
And this fella?
Well, that's their business.
Oh, that's the world's business. The world's business is kindness and gentleness and evil and brutality. What else is there, mister?
Well, there's a whole lot else besides. Like lust and greed and stupidity.
Oh, Mr. Jones is stupid. Oh, Jones is old. Oh, Jones has cooked himself in the sun. I know, I know.
Get yourself something to eat.
There's fellas need help. Maybe this fella can help them.
Maybe. They're on the run.
That ain't my business. My business is what they do hereafter. That's my business.
Well, they certainly need money.
Yeah, there's always money. Money for them is good, and money for them is not so good. But maybe they could first go see the sheriffs and see what work is afoot. I reckon, for now at least, we might as well try. The sheriff at Blackwater, he needs help. No, not the fella that arrested you. That was the marshal. The police chief, he's a decent enough fella for all we know. Poor bastard is overrun, and he don't want old Jones.
There's a couple other sheriffs that need help. A fella from Valentine, he's at the Painted Sky Ranch. The Tumbleweed Sheriff's at the Tumbleweed Jail, and the Blackwater Sheriff, he's at Pike's Basin.
Maybe that'll show us what kind of fella this is. Go and pay them all a call. That's what I reckon.
Maybe. I guess we will see. Meet me back here after you've seen them.
Let's go.
So, what are you after? Fly it high and proud. All right, you know where to find me.
Fancy seeing you here.
Hey, welcome.
You there.
Been some bad business up on the ridge. Thieves. Hijacked a caravan and ran off with our goods. I would normally leave this kind of thing alone, but the company is offering quite a reward here. And maybe that would be of interest to you? I thought it might. Okay, off you go. Like I said, it was up on Roanoke Ridge. Bring it in and you'll be paid.
Yeah.
People fear you.
Hello, stranger.
You don't got the eye. Just an eye for a deal.
I told you, go away, old man.
Nothing but false prophecies and fake jewelry.
Go away, or I see much pain and suffering in your future.
A crook and a charlatan. Make sure you know what you're getting into with this one.
Hey, please, don't listen to him. I am Madame Nassar. Channeler of spirits, finder of lost things, and, since everyone seems to be a fortune teller now, seller of the strange and exotic. Which one of these can I help you with today? Wait, don't speak. Let me see. Yes. Yes. You're searching for something. What though? A dead lover. Whose spirit you wish to contact on the other side? No, no, it's not that. It's not something you've lost, but something you're missing. Yes, purpose. Some meaning in the chaos of this life. Well, you see, that is something I can help you with. Come to work for me. I say I find things, but really, it is others who do the finding. I tell them what I'm looking for, and they collect it for me from far and wide. Sometimes it is, and sometimes through great hardship. It is work that can be as honest or dishonest as you want it to be. How about it? Do you want to be one of my collectors? I make sure they are rewarded quite handsomely. A small fee is really the least I should ask for giving you what you're looking for and setting you up with everything you need to get started. There are more tools you may want from me in due course, but first, you will need to prove yourself. If you don't want to start now, you can find me again, and the offer will still be there. Ah, if money is the problem, then that is the first thing you should go looking for. When you found some, return to me. And I set you on your way. What a dark shadow you cast.
People walk it all to come and see me. Ask me about the painting in the rock. Some things are not for even me to know. Items I'm as a very regular, a list of desirable items every now and then. Keep an eye out for it. Opportunities to come to you. If the sea takes a ship, you should be waiting on the shore to see what washes up. One or two new things today. Granite hurts. Every time a train passes along it, I think it will break. Perhaps one day it will. There are some things I would like especially. Of course, I pay handsomely for them. I send my list of desirables by post sometimes, and don't worry, I know where to find you. My best collectives all have one thing in common. They are opportunists. If there is...
just glad to finally...
Thank you.
I thought you said they'd be here.
That's what I thought.
Is this them?
Nope. Oh, there they are in the wagon. That's her.
Whoa, there. You all looking for the Twin Rocks gang?
Isn't everybody?
I got them for you. In the back. Go ahead. Count them up. They're all there.
God damn! One, two, two and a half.
Let me get you your money. That's something. Bringing all them boys in, you know.
Bounty hunting ain't so hard. Any fool can do it.
I ain't so sure.
How about you there? You fool enough to try? Become a bounty hunter? There's a board up in most every jailhouse and post office. The sheet's going up regular. All you need is a license, which the sheriff will sell you. You can take down a poster and go. Alive, get your full price. Dead, a little less. You go after one of the big ones, I'll tell you what I know about them, as a favor. The worst that can happen is they kill you.
There's only 9. I counted them twice.
There was 10 when I pulled up. I know you're hiding out there. You got 10 seconds to turn yourself in. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
No.
2.
No, please.
1.
Please, no.
There's your tent.
Clean it up, Archibald.
If it ain't all here, I will be back.
I'm sure you will.
That one there might want a bounty hunting license. Help him out, won't you?
That true? You want a license? Out of money, huh? Well, if you don't have it now, you can come and get a license when you do. They sell them wherever they hang them posters. Good luck now.
Tina found herself a necklace in Jim's pocket the other day. Ruby the size of a fist.
Well, I'll be flayed and displayed.
Burns' poor horse got bit by a snake. His balls blew up the size of balloons before it died.
Welcome, welcome.
Well, okay. We got some deliveries need making. This is the kind of drudgery they hope will soften our minds, but you and me are smarter than that. Discouraged, but undiminished. Yes, indeed. The bags are outside. Just take them where they need to go. Take their money, but don't let them take your pride. Go and grab them now. Good luck.
Well,
I'll be here.
Thank you.
too long ago.
Here, this has got to
Madam,
stop!
Madam, please!
No!
I'll be right with you.
I know you're up there!
Oh, marvelous. There she is. Just what I need. The crazy wood nymph. Can't a man take a bath in peace?
What the hell is that?
It's a panther!
You savage!
And a nice clean one now, too. This is going above the mayor's bed. Okay, Mrs. Hobbs will be by to handle the taxidermy.
Oh, travel safe, my friend.
Wait, who are you? Where's Cecil?
Glenn, I'm a friend of his. Cecil had to take a few days off.
Mm-hmm.
For stress.
Is there any animal that you have not slaughtered?
Oh, you flatter me, Miss Davenport.
Sorry, I really will be right with you.
The answer's no, but I'm retired, as you know, and have been for some time.
Yes, and how many have you out there killing for you now?
Not nearly enough, I'm afraid. Business is booming. What about you there? You a hunter? Gus McMillan, master craftsman of fine clothing and accessories. Here's my card. I pay top dollar for animal furs and parts. The rarer, the better.
Don't listen to him. Unbelievable. How do you sleep at night?
On a tiger bedspread, my dear. Seriously, come see
me. You're no better than a murderer. And one day, you'll be seen as such.
Whoa. Would you mind taking us outside? I don't worry.
Shut up, Glenn!
Listen, soon as a squirrel finds a cure for tuberculosis, let's talk.
If intelligence is the barometer of who has the right to live or die, you should have been court-martialed at birth!
Annoying, isn't she? See him? The only thing he had on his mind was hunger, sweetheart, but I pulled the trigger. Survival of the fittest. Isn't that your mentor's trite catchphrase?
It's not survival of the fittest. You are killing to line your own pockets.
This is how I make my living. We don't all have a rich daddy. While you're camped out in the woods making witches' brews and talking to the wildlife, the rest of us are doing some real work.
You think this is some big joke?
Crazy shrew. They should throw you in an asylum.
That's it. I quit. You can tell the mayor I've gone home.
Oh, sorry about that awful man. Harriet Davenport. I've been in the field now for 3 years, studying the hidden interconnections between animals of all species. I've seen everything. I've had joy, disgust, regrets, envy. We're so much more alike than we are different. I'm on the brink of discovering the pathways that link all life. I just need more research material. I have in here detailed notes on pretty much every animal from armadillo to Annisburg, including the locations of some truly impressive varieties. I would be willing to sell this to you if you will commit to bringing me anatomical samples from live species and promise not to carry out any more animal side in pursuit of Gus McMillan's greed. I'll pay you, of course. I promise I'm good for the money. You don't have to decide right now. Just think about it. We've been brought together for a reason. I feel that very strongly. I've been experimenting with tonics that can provide access to remarkable new pathways of communication with other species. You have to live as they do, eat as they eat. Hop as the toad, dig as the mole, love as the badger. If you see what I've seen, you just have to open your mind. Join me on a voyage of discovery.
Oh!
can do about it, Sheriff.
About what?
My stolen property.
Well, ain't much I can do about it. I ain't got the manpower to go after Bob Crawfish. Howdy.
How do? I pay your goddamn wages, me and folks like me.
Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Arnsdale. Really, I am. But there ain't nothing I can do about this. Not without more support and funding.
Will you go for me?
Wait, what?
Go. See if you can retrieve my lawful property from some goddamn thieves.
Ain't nobody knows who took your stuff, mister.
I seem like some kind of liar. Is that why you won't help me?
No, but...
Listen. Get me Bob Crawfish and his closest associates by any means necessary.
No. Not by any means necessary. Kill nobody. Ain't nobody convicted of nothing.
I was robbed. Get them and bring them to me just down from Fort Riggs Station, and you will be handsomely paid. Sheriff.
Mr. Arnsdale.
Upper Montana, we'll lose them on the river. Let's split up now. See you on the river. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
you killed weren't good men. You can still put this right. Here he is, of course. Keeping his hands clean as usual. Hello, Bob.
Old friend. Nice to see you.
What's your problem?
Put him on the tracks. Come on.
Hello, Clinton.
Hello, Clinton. How have you been since we robbed you? Where's my property?
I don't rightly know what you're talking about,
yes,
Clinton.
Yes, you do. My fine collection of Staffordshire china, gone. My paintings of scenes in Italy, gone. My collection of photographs of fairies, gone.
It's all just a big mistake.
Where are they?
We invested in them together. You owed us money.
I did no such thing. Where are my things?
In the basement of your sister's house.
My sister? Goddamn her to hell. Here. Here's your money. Kill these men, will you? In fact, don't kill them. Leave them on the tracks. Thieves!
You're not gonna let some good old boys die because of some Staffordshire china and an argument between a man and his sister.
Get these robes off,
please. Think about this.
Oh, I knew you were greedy.
I didn't realize you were evil.
Cold-blooded killers. That's what you are. This is a black mark on all of you.
Thank you.
wonderful. A customer.
Hello there. Pleased to see you.
You here for work, Dan?
So long. Remember, train's always running.
Off you pop, Dan. All right, you're the new one, old and sent. Thinks he's some criminal mastermind these days. This is the last thing I need right now. All right, well, I suppose we might as well both get paid. So I'm guessing you're not just here to pass the time of day. Okay, so what is it they want you doing now? Ah, yes, a supply wagon. They're looking for someone to ensure a safe passage up to O'Cray's run. Hopefully you won't have to shoot too many people, but it's okay if you're getting paid, right?
Thank you.